All right, so this is Kenny Santos, out of Toronto, Canada, for KennySantos.com. It is Wednesday, so it's time for another personal development tip. Today, we're going to be talking about how to find your purpose. But before I get into that, if you like my blog, if you like my videos, if you like my content, then I invite you to like, subscribe, share, comment. It is an awesome way for you to support my channel and my blog, and it doesn't cost you a cent. So let's get into it. How would we find our purpose? Unfortunately, many people, most people, like 90 plus percent of people, probably 95 plus percent of people, they never get to find their purpose. They have these lofty dreams than when they were children, and then they grow up, they let life get in the way, and they don't find their purpose, and that's kind of sad. And what's sadder than not finding your purpose is when people stop looking. You know, instead of surviving, or instead of thriving, they're just mentally surviving. Instead of living, they're just kind of existing. They're not getting everything full out of life. And it reminds me of this quote that Marie Forleo says at the end of all of her videos and the end of all of her podcasts. She says, "The world needs that special gift that only you can provide. And if you don't find that gift and you don't give it to the world, not only are you sacrificing a much happier life and a much more productive life, you're ripping off the world of your particular gift because only you can provide it. But what if you're one of those people that live day to day? You're living the same day. Every Monday is the same. Actually, every weekday is the same. You wake up, maybe you have the same food. You go to the same job. You see the same people. Maybe you don't even like the job. And maybe you kind of like the people. Maybe you don't. But then you come home and you spend the night or the evening just trying to unwind, all ready to do it again the next day. Now, what I invite you to do is this, is whether you were living in that groundhog routine or not, is that in your spare time, instead of choosing to spend that time unwinding in front of a TV or, you know, out drinking with the guys or whatever that is that might be unproductive, choose to do something that is productive, that does bring value to the world. Maybe you have an old hobby that you used to do when you were younger that you kind of let go when you let life get in the way, and you'd be happy picking that hobby back up. For example, it could be knitting, all right? Knitting could bring value to the world. Maybe you make mittens and hats, and you start, if they bring value to the world, maybe you just start selling them. And it might not be a lot of money at first, you know? It might not replace your job, but at least you're doing something, and you never know what that side project that you love to do can turn into. You know, a lot of people, they want to start a side business, and they pick their business based on how much money they can make. You know what? I think I'm going to open up a franchise because franchises make a lot of money. And then they're picking their, you know, that's what they think to themselves. And they're picking their business as a means to an end. But what's interesting is that success, you've heard it before, success is the journey. It's not the end point. And if you don't like what you're doing, if you think, you know what, I'm going to start some franchise and you don't even like that work, then what good is it if you work 40 years there and you become financially free? You know, you might as well be working a job. But what if you're doing something that you love, whether it's knitting or fishing or playing an instrument or whatever that case may be? Let's take the example of knitting. You know, a hobby of knitting can go from just making hats and mittens for your friends. It could turn into a thriving business where people are ordering from you online. You got to get it outsourced. It could turn into a charity that provides mittens and hats for the homeless. It could be a combination of the two. You never know what that can grow into. And that's the wonderful thing about taking risks and about taking chances. Because if you take a risk, at least you know that you tried. You never have to ask yourself, well, what if? You have that peace of mind knowing, well, it's not knitting. That's not my purpose. Maybe it's something else. Because another thing that Marie Forleo says is that if you're not sure, just try it, all right? Clarity comes from engagement, not thoughts. That's what she says. She says, clarity comes from engagement, not thought. And so as you're trying these different projects, instead of wasting your life away hanging out, drinking with the boys, or watching TV, you could be doing something productive. You could be living your life. And what if that side project replaces your current income and you're finally getting paid for being you? You're getting paid to do what you love. That is success, and that is your purpose in life. And so I trust you got some great value out of this. What I invite you to do is this: like, subscribe, share, comment. Also, if you want to see more videos just like this, go over to my blog. It's KennySantos.com. You put your name and email in, you're going to get an awesome audio and growing your business. And remember this: every day, multiple times a day, the universe sends us miracles. We only got to do two things. We got to recognize those miracles, and of course, we got to accept them. All right, take care and create a great day.